So air molecules, the molecules are far away. So if you put even a little, if you irritate them even a little, they will vibrate faster because there's a lot of space. Liquid molecules are a little more packed. That's why liquid is a liquid. It's a little more packed, needs a little more irritation, and then those molecules will vibrate faster. In a solid like this table here, the molecules are very densely packed. There's no place to move. So it will take a little more of irritation to make them move very fast and create heat in this. So air, because there's a lot of space, will heat up fast, very fast. Liquids will take a little more time, and solids like this will take a lot more time. That's why if you put food into an oven, a microwave oven, the dish will take longer to heat up than the little soft food or the curry that you put inside. Yes? Normally when you use a microwave oven, you will heat the food for what? A minute? 2 minutes? Now what if you heat that food for 2 hours? What if you heated that food for 2 months? And then for 2 years? Okay. When you are sold a microwave oven, there are guidelines on how you can use it. They say when you want to use it, you turn it on, you close the door. You close the door of the microwave oven. You step back from it. Ideally, you step back. Because some of those radio waves travel out of that transparent door in the front. And they don't want that to be in contact with you, come in contact with you. So they tell you to step back. When it goes ding, the food is hot, you move. You actually are supposed to give it a few seconds before all that radio wave activity dies down inside. Then you open the door and then you put your food in. You don't immediately go and yank your hand in, ideally. Pregnant women are advised not to use microwave ovens, to stay away. So what I want you to remember is that radio waves used for cell phones are closest in range to microwaves. Okay, so for our phones to work, there's two parts to the story. There's a cell phone and then there's an antenna. Right? You need these two things to make a cell phone work. Let's see, how does a cell phone work? Now, you may be, all of you have your phones in your hands, in your bags, and you're thinking of sitting there doing nothing. No, it's still working. Every 40, 50 seconds, a signal is going from your phone. If it's on, it is going to the nearest antenna to give attendance. I'm here. Because otherwise, how is that antenna to know which cell phone is sitting where? So every 40, 50 seconds, your phone is connecting to the antenna with an airwave. Boom, goes there, connects. Now if you have Wi-Fi, and if you have Twitter, and you have emails coming down, what's happening? There's more working going on. Yeah? It's coming down, all your notifications are coming, your emails are dropping in. So there's a lot of activity. Tejal here, my assistant, is now going to help us with a little demonstration. It is quite interesting. So we have Miss Doshi's number, and you are going to call her up. So she is going to call up Miss Doshi here. So let's hear that. So she dials out the number. What happens? The airwave goes to the nearest antenna. The antenna figures out, oh, Miss Doshi's right here. And the signal comes back here from the antenna. Okay, we've got music there. So great. What does this mean? This airwave traveled out of this building to reach that antenna. That antenna is maybe 2 buildings away. It has crossed these buildings. It travels through these materials. Yeah. Now, Miss Doshi, I'd like you to sit on your phone. Yeah, just sit on it. Please. Guys, sounds a little funny, but yeah, please, Tejal, if you could He's flat again. Now let's see what happens. Okay, let us know in case we can't hear it. Whether it's ringing down there. Wowzy. And there was not an inch of air around it. So what has happened? This airway has traveled out and then come back to Mrs. Doshi, and it has traveled possibly through her body, through that chair, to reach her phone. Now, we're going to just wrap her cell phone in the aluminium foil that you use for packing your sandwiches for kids at school, which I think we must minimize because aluminium is not a great thing for your food. But so here we're just going to completely pack her phone with the aluminium foil, and Tejal is again going to try her and see if she can get through. Alright, so again she has dialed out, the airway is gone there. Is it? Is it ringing? It isn't ringing. What does it say? It's happening. Oh, I think we need to put a little more oil on that. Yeah, please. So some of the air is still able to get in. We'll just sort of pack the aluminium in a way that the air can't quite get in. Okay, now it's just completely packed with aluminium foil. That's all that's happened. We're just trying to minimize, not minimize, we're trying to cut out the contact with air or atmosphere. We're just trying to block it completely.
Can we just see the radiation pattern?
So that's supposedly an antenna there. So intense radiation here, very high, medium, low. So it keeps decreasing with the distance. There is also some radiation just behind the antenna. So that's why I wonder when, you know, people have antennas just outside their windows, and if there is no metal sheet behind it to block what's going on, I sometimes wonder what is the effect on the people who are being exposed to it, who are living just behind that antenna. So as you see above and below the antenna, there will be little radiation, but intensely here in the front. Okay. If you want to increase the radiation, you just have to increase the power output from this antenna, and this whole thing will increase. Which is what happens when there are peak hours of traffic, there are peak hours of calls. And during those times, companies need to ramp up the absorbing power of these antennas. So they increase the power output so that more calls can be handled. Antennas have to work 24/7. They have to work morning, night, noon, all the time. Because you might wake up at 3 a.m. and say, gosh, where's my husband gone? He hasn't come.